Actually, we have started this concept of electric current, or we have introduced this concept of electric current in the last lecture. Now we are trying to proceed. Now we are trying to proceed towards the definition of electric current. Electric current will be a new quantity for you, just like as you people did so many other quantities with me in the syllabus of our physics. As an example, force is the name of a quantity which you people have studied with me. Acceleration is the name of a quantity. Heat capacity, specific heat capacity. And in this way, I can name so many different quantities which you people have already studied in this course of physics. So today, we need to proceed. We need to define a new quantity called electric current, which is also such an important quantity that almost in the whole left syllabus, almost in the whole next syllabus, the definition of electric quantity will be required. Last time, what we did? Last time I have introduced you, I have told you that we need a positively charged body and a negatively charged body. We need a positively charged body and a negatively charged body if we want to make the electrons flow. If we want to make the charged particles flow, and electron is an example of a charged particle. We all know that electrons are negatively charged bodies. Electrons are the negatively charged particles. So what am I trying to say? That all we need is a positively charged substance, a positively charged object, a positively charged body, and a negatively charged substance or a negatively charged body. If we'll join a negatively charged body and a positively charged body by the help of a copper wire. If we'll join a negatively charged substance and a positively charged substance by the help of a copper wire, then the electron starts flowing in the specific direction. Beta, the electrons were already present in the copper wire. And these electrons also were not tightly bound with their respective nuclei. You all know that copper is a metal. In case of copper, the electrons are loosely bound, so that's why electrons were flowing. Electrons were already flowing in the copper wire, but not flowing in a specific direction. Electrons were flowing in random directions, in different random directions. But the moment we are going to join a positively charged object and a negatively charged object by the help of a copper wire, now all the electrons starts flowing in a specific direction, or the electron starts flowing in a specific direction. This specific direction will be the electron starts flowing from the negatively charged rod towards the positively charged rod. This rod is negatively charged, means it is showing efficiency of electrons. So many extra electrons are present over this rod, that's why it is called a negatively charged rod. Similarly, there is a deficiency of electron on this particular positively charged rod. Electrons are less than requirement. So this particular rod is behaving as a positively charged object or a positively charged substance. So when we have joined by the help of a copper wire, the electron starts flowing. Electron starts flowing from the negatively charged object towards the positively charged object. This is a specific direction of flow. This is a particular direction of flow of charged particle. This is a particular direction of flow for an electron. The people of science in those days, there are so many people who have worked in order to develop this particular concept of electric current in the history of science. As an example, in those days, a scientist named Volta was working in this. A scientist named Edison Edison, who has invented the electric bulb, the very first electric bulb of the world, was working on it. And Volta, who has invented the very first source which make the electrons flow of the world. And later on, we are going to name this source as a cell. The cell will be a body, cell will be a object. Cell will be a body, cell will be an object which contains a positively charged terminal or a positively charged body, a negatively charged terminal or a negatively charged body into it. I repeat, the people of science, the brains of sciences have identified that this is a very important concept some 300 years ago. Some 250, around 300 years ago, they have identified that this particular form of energy is going to serve us in the future. So they want to construct a body which was later on, which would have been called a cell, the very first cell, the Volta's cell. The Volta's cell was an object in which we have two terminals. The one terminal is a positively charged body and the other terminal is a negatively charged body. And electrons do flow from a negatively charged body, negatively charged terminal, to a positively charged body, to a positively charged terminal, when are being joined together by the help of a copper wire. Because when electrons do flow through the copper wire, it means electrical energy, the kinetic energy of the electrons, which was later on named as the electrical energy, is present in the copper wire. And when that particular copper wire is cut into two halves and a lamp or an electric bulb or an electric lamp is being joined. Now we all know that this particular symbol can be used for a lamp or a bulb. The symbol is a small circle with a cross sign inside of it. Whenever we want to draw a lamp, a filament lamp, a bulb, or an electric lamp in a given circuit or in a circuit, we are going to introduce this particular symbol. Just like as you can see in this diagram, a lamp is being introduced by the help of a symbol. These are the connecting wires. These are connecting wire, our connecting wire, both are the connecting wires which have joined the lamp. And there is a cell. Cell is actually a body, an object. As an example, the very first cell in the world, the Volta cell, actually contains a positive terminal and a negative terminal. There is one terminal, one object, which is behaving as a positive terminal into it, and another object which is behaving as a negative terminal into it. And the Volta cell was being made by the help of those chemical agents which were present in the cell, and those chemical agents have the duty. I repeat, Vita, please listen it carefully. Those chemical agents have the duty to do work and dissipate their chemical energy and convert that chemical energy into electrical energy. I repeat this concept again, please listen it carefully. I'm in no hurry at all. Initially, the more time we'll spend later on, the more grasp we'll have on this concept of electric current. So please listen it carefully again. Volta's cell was being made up by the help of a positively charged terminal and a negatively charged terminal. Now you know, when the positively charged terminal or body and negatively charged terminal or body are being joined together by the help of connecting wires, electrons flow from the negatively charged terminal towards the positively charged terminal. What does it mean? It means electrons are going to be decreased on the negatively charged terminal, and now the negatively charged terminal wants to become neutral. Electrons, when reached to the positively charged terminal, it is going to reduce the positive charge. I'm repeating it again, Bachcha. I'm repeating it over and over again until and unless you will give me a signal to proceed. I'm saying that this particular terminal is a negatively charged body. It has an efficiency of electrons. This particular terminal is a positively charged terminal. It has a deficiency of electrons. when we are going to join this negative terminal and this positive terminal, a longer vertical line is representing a positive terminal in this cell, in this symbol of cell, and a smaller vertical line is representing a negative terminal or a negative body in this symbol of cell. I repeat, in the above diagram, you know, there was a positively charged rod, there was a negatively charged rod, and we have joined these two rods by the help of a copper wire. We have also introduced a lamp or a filament lamp inside or in between that copper wire. I have drawn the same diagram below here. The same diagram is being drawn below here. This is a symbol of lamp, the symbol of connecting wire. This is the symbol of connecting wire. This is also a symbol or a connecting wire is being shown in this diagram. And also the positively charged rod or a negatively charged rod, positively charged rod and a negatively charged rod are being shown in the symbol of cell. What does cell contain? Cell contains a positively charged terminal, which is being shown by the help of a longer vertical line, and a negatively charged terminal, which is being shown by the help of a smaller vertical line. So there is a negative terminal or a negative body. There is a positive terminal or a positive body present in the cell. Now, when we people, the people of science, have connected those negative charge terminal and a positive charge terminal, electrons flow from the negatively charged terminal towards the positively charged terminal. What does it mean? I repeat, it means the electrons are going to flow, means electrons are going to be decreased. The extra electrons are going to become lesser and lesser on the negatively charged terminals, because these electrons are departing negatively charged terminal and have now reached to the positive charged terminal. It means this negatively charged terminals is going to reduce its negativity, and until and unless it becomes neutral once again. On the other hand, this positively charged terminal is receiving electrons, so it means its positivity is going to be decreased until and unless it also becomes neutral. So both are trying to become neutral, because electrons or extra electrons are flowing from the negatively charged terminals towards the positively charged terminals. But in order to make them negative again, in order to make them positive again, Volta has introduced at least two chemical agents in his first world's Volta's cell. The first word cell was named as Volta cell because it was being invented by Volta. Volta was the name of the scientist, V-O-L-T-A. It was the name of the scientist. And as he has invented the first world cell, so the first world cell was being named on his name. So what does it contain? G-meter.
Sir, Walter introduced two chemicals that would make sure that the terminals remain negative and positive and would not become neutral.
For the specific period of time, if we are not going to introduce the chemical agents, what does happen? The negatively charged terminal becomes neutral in a fraction of a second. The positively charged terminal becomes neutral in a fraction of a second. And we don't want to pass electric current through the lamp only for a fraction of a second. We want to pass the electric current through the lamp in those days for at least half an hour, for at least 1 hour, for at least one and a half hour, for at least 2 hours. It was a dream of science that we can light up the lamp for 1 hour after sunset. We can light up the lamp for 2 hours after sunset. So all Volta has done in those days, that Volta has introduced the chemical agents, and the duty of the chemical agents was to do work. I repeat, Beta, please listen it carefully. To do work, the work done was being done by those chemical agents in order to convert their chemical energy into electrical energy again. In order to rise the negative charges, the falling negative charges, the reducing negative charges once again up to the maximum limit. And in order to rise the positive charges once again up to the maximum positive limit. बेटा सम 8 or 10 years ago, the Volta cell or the function of the Volta cell was the part of our syllabus. And in that particular article, it was very easy for the physics teacher to introduce you people that how does Volta cells work. But now it is not part of our syllabus, so that's why I have to introduce a summary, only a summary of the function of Volta's cell. I don't want to go into the complete details of Volta's cell in my regular class. Somewhere in the future, if you people want to study the function of the Volta's cell, I can teach you in some extra class. But in the regular
Sir,
class, yeah.
you are
Come
saying that the positive charges also travel towards the negative?
Beta, at the present moment, I have only introduced the flow of negative charges, the flow of electrons, and electrons always flow from the negative terminal to the positive terminal. I am not talking at all. At the present moment, any flow of positive charge, any flow of conventional current. ठीक है, सो एट द प्रेजेंट मोमेंट प्लीज इग्नोर ऑल अदर फ्लोज एंड जस्ट कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन द फ्लो ऑफ नेगेटिव चार्जेस. ओके,
Also, sir, the chemicals introduced in the water cell change chemical energy to electrical energy, right?
यस, एग्जैक्टली एग्जैक्टली. ऑल आई वांट टू इंट्रोड्यूस, ऑल आई नीड एट द प्रेजेंट मोमेंट, नॉट द डिटेल्स ऑफ वोल्टास सेल्स फंक्शन, but only I want to introduce here that cell is the name of a body. The cell is the name of a body in which we have one terminal as a positively charged terminal, one terminal as a negatively charged terminal, and at least, I said, at least two chemical agents. And the function of that chemical agents is that the one agent is going to make the negative charge again as negative, the falling negative charge. I repeat, the falling negative charge again as negative up to its total capacity, and the falling positive charge again to a positive charge up to its total capacity for a specific period of time. As an example, nowadays we have cells which can work for a month, which can work for an year. We have cells. Cells are being used in our houses in so many different electrical devices. Most of the wall clocks which are being used in our houses, I repeat, most of the wall clocks which are being used in our houses do contain cells. And those cells can function for a year, for 2 years, for 3 years now. Now, the cells can function for 1 year or 2 years or 3 years. What does it mean? It means it do contains some chemical agents, and the duty of those chemical agents to fulfill the requirement to make the specific number of negative charges and positive charges once again, because these negative charges and positive charges do fall when are being joined together by the help of connecting wire. So just suppose if our wall clock is present in place of a lamp here. So when we use the cell inside the wall clock, electrons do flow from the negative terminal of the cell towards the positive terminal of the cell. And in that particular flow, the electrons also pass through the function motor, the small functional motor which is present inside the wall clock. So when electrons do flow through the small functional motor present inside the wall clock, the clock keeps ticking on. The clock keeps functioning. Clock keeps functioning. So it means the duty of the cell is to make the electrons flow for a specific period of time. And cell cannot do this without the help of chemical agents. It is the duty of chemical agents that when electrons flow from the negative terminal towards the positive terminal, when the quantity of electrons fall on the negative terminal, when the quantity of positive charge fall on the positive terminal, chemical agents once again make that quantity appropriate so that it will keep on flowing for the whole year if this particular cell is made to flow the electrons for the whole year.
Sir,
Yes, my child, any question?
Sir, so can we say that the chemical agents causes the positive and the negative terminal to reboost, के यानी वो वापस उस तरह जैसे पहले था?
Exactly, exactly. The role of the chemical agents is, which is being introduced by me right now at the present moment, is that those chemical agents have the duty to make the number of negative charges once again up to the appropriate limit, once again up to the maximum limit, because these were being reduced when they do flow from the negative terminal to the positive terminal. And when those electrons have reached to the positive terminals, the charge of the positive terminal is also being reduced. And there is another chemical agent, its duty is to once again make the positive charges up to the maximum limit. And they'll keep on doing it. In that particular function, they need to perform the work. They need to dissipate their chemical energy. So they are continuously dissipating their chemical energy, and that particular chemical energy is continuously being converted into electrical energy. Electrical energy is the name of the energy which is being used by me for the very first time in my today's lecture. Actually, this electrical energy is the energy due to which the electrons are flowing, or electrons have the kinetic energy. All you know that electrons are flowing in a specific direction now, from the negatively charged terminal towards the positively charged terminal. It means now they have a kinetic energy which is in a specific direction also. So that particular energy is being named by us throughout this chapter and the next chapters also as electrical energy. Any question? Come on, shabash, question, bacha.
Sir, what do you mean when you say that the chemical agent has or needs to dissipate their energy?
Beta, actually, step by step, we are proceeding into the article of Volta's cell's functionality. This one by one, if I'm going to answer your all questions, it means actually we'll be doing the article of how Volta's cell function. And once again, I need to repeat here that this particular article is no more the part of our syllabus now. So later on, if you people will feel that it is very important to know about this article, I can teach this article too in some extra class. But as far as our regular class is concerned, I am trying. At the present moment, I am trying to talk the minimum possible, talk minimum possible about the Volta cell, or talk about the Volta cell as much as required. So once again, I'll try to summarize the Volta cell by using the minimum possible words, and that is that this function of the Volta cell is actually the world's first cell is actually, and later on all the cells which were being invented in the world was actually being inspired by the Volta cell, was actually being made by the formula given by the scientist named Volta. What Volta did in the Volta cell was that Volta has introduced two terminals, two word terminals. One is positively charged terminal and one is negatively charged terminal. Volta has introduced two terminals, one positively charged terminal and one as negatively charged terminal. These terminals are being made once again positive up to a maximum extent, once again negative up to a maximum extent by the help of those chemical agents which were also being introduced in the Volta cell. As an example, okay, explaining a little bit further is, the chemical agent which was being used by the Volta was dilute sulfuric acid H2SO4. You all know, you all are the students of chemistry. You all know dilute sulfuric acid H2SO4 decomposed itself into H plus ions and into SO4 minus 2 ions. I repeat, H plus 1 ions and SO4 minus 2 ions. Every molecule of H2SO4, when decomposed itself into two H plus 1 ions and one SO4 minus 2 ions, so SO4 minus 2 ions and H plus 1 ions have the duty. When H2SO4 is being decomposed into H plus ions and SO4 minus 2 ions, it means H2SO4 is dissipating, is finishing its identity. I repeat, Listen it once again carefully, bacha. I'm not going to talk about these things in a regular class again because it is beyond the limits of our syllabus. But considering it as a first lecture, so that's why I'm a little bit introducing it further, that when H2SO4 molecule decompose itself, when H2SO4 decompose itself into two H plus one ions and one SO4 minus two ions, it means H2SO4 molecule has finished its identity, has dissipated its identity, has dissipated its chemical energy, has finished its chemical energy. So H2SO4 is finishing itself, is dying itself, is dissipating itself, is dissipating its chemical energy just for the sake of that later on H2 plus ion has the duty. I repeat, please listen it carefully. H2 plus one ion has the duty to make the positive terminal once again further positive. Once again, positive up to the maximum limit. Yes, I have spoken it correctly. H plus one ion has the duty. H plus one ion has the duty to make the positive terminal of the Volta cell as positive once again up to the maximum limit. And SO4 minus two ion has the duty. SO4 minus two ion has the duty to make the negative terminal as negative up to the maximum limit once again. So what does it mean? It means that chemical energy is dissipating itself because H2SO4 is dissipating itself. And that particular chemical energy is making the positive terminal positive up to the maximum extent once again. Negative terminal is negative up to the maximum extent once again. Means this energy, this chemical energy has done work and converted itself into an electrical energy. Now, beta, I think it's okay for a regular lecture. Any question?
Question.
Ji, shabash.
Sir, ye jo H plus hai, to wo apne positive ions, yani positive energy, usko positive terminal ko de deta hai, aur SO2 minus 4 apni negative usko.
Yes. H plus ion has a very strong chemical reaction with the material with which the positively charged terminal is being made. Listen this sentence carefully again. H plus, very intelligently, Volta has constructed the positive terminal with a material, the positive terminal with a material, which has a very, very strong chemical reaction with the H plus ions. So even there was a force of repulsion present between the positive terminal and the H plus ion. By doing work against that force of repulsion, H plus ion has reached to the positive terminal because very intelligently, Volta has constructed the positive terminal with a material. Which has a very strong chemical reaction. Such a strong chemical reaction that although there was a force of repulsion present there, H plus ion has reached to the positive terminal and enhanced its positive charge by taking or by snatching electron from it. Two H plus ions have reached to the positive terminal, taken one electron each, make themselves neutral, make themselves as a molecule of hydrogen gas, escaped out of the cell, and in this way the positive charge of the positive terminal is being increased. So bit by bit I am actually teaching you the concept of the function of Volta's cell. Okay, no problem. Any question?
Sir, is dilute sulfuric acid only one of the chemical agents, because you said that there were two?
Normally in most of the cells there are two different chemical agents. The duty of one chemical agent, as an example, H plus ions has the duty of increasing the positive charge of the positively charged terminal up to a maximum extent, and the duty of the negative SO4 minus two ions is to increase the negative charges on the negatively charged terminal up to the maximum extent. So normally two chemical agents are required in order for the function of a cell. Ji beta, do I proceed? Are you with me, bachcho? This whole particular concept is just being introduced in order to define electric current. I am in no hurry at all in the beginning, because in the beginning, sir, if we'll spend more time later on, we are going to understand our concept in a better manner. Are you with me? We are on the, are we on the same page? Do I proceed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, in a nutshell, I'm trying to summarize this concept so that I can proceed towards the definition of electric current. And the summary is, all what is being required to know by you people is that I have introduced a cell in this circuit diagram. Overall, this particular diagram will be named as circuit diagram later on by us. And we are going to plot so many different circuit diagrams in this chapter and in the next chapters also, that over and over again, when you people are going to plot it by your hand, you people will know, will learn all those symbols. This is the symbol of cell. A longer vertical line will show the positively charged terminal. A smaller vertical line will show the negatively charged terminal. These two terminals, negatively charged and positively charged terminals, are being joined together by the help of a connecting wire. We have also introduced a lamp in between. When electrons do flow through the lamp, when electrons will flow through the lamp, we people can see, or we people will see, that this lamp will lit up. This lamp is going to be lit up. Now you people have to concentrate on this video. So a cell is required. If electrons has to be made flow in a particular specific direction, and if a positive terminal and a negative terminal of the cell is being connected by the help of a copper wire, then electron starts flowing through it. As an example, you people can see in this animation, you can see that there is a cell. What does volt mean? Later on, I'm going to explain, inshallah, in my next lecture, I'll explain what does volt mean. At the present moment, you people can see this is not the symbol of cell. This has been actual cell is being shown here. All you need to draw is the symbol of cell, a longer line and a smaller vertical line. Or we can also show a longer horizontal line and a smaller horizontal line in the case of present diagram. So cell is being introduced here. There is a connecting wire, and this connecting wire is connecting the positive and negative terminal of the cells. You people can see the actual lamp. Here the actual filament lamp is being shown. And you people can see that one terminal, one end point of the copper wire is connected with one end of the filament lamp. The second is being connected with the second end of the filament lamp. Do remember, listen by this sentence very carefully. Do remember, every electrical appliance, whether it is an electric lamp or an air conditioner or a refrigerator or all kinds of electrical appliances which are going to be used by us in our daily life, or which are going to be used by us in studying the next three or four chapters, definitely contains two terminals or two endpoints, or the two points where this particular appliance can be joined by the help of copper wires. Similarly, this lamp has the two endpoints. This is one endpoint. Please watch the cursor carefully. This is the one endpoint of the filament lamp. This is the second endpoint of the filament lamp. And you people can see that a copper wire, one end of the copper wire is connected with the end point of the filament lamp, the other end with the negative terminal of the battery. This is being connected with the one end point of the filament lamp, the other end with the positive terminal of the battery. When current do flow through it, look at it. This is an animation. This is an animation. And in this animation, we can see the moment electric current will flow, the moment electric current will flow, it also flows through the filament lamp of the electrical or cell is there, filament lamp is there, electric current or electrons are flowing through the filament of the lamp. And when electrons do flow through the filament lamp, the electrical energy converts itself into light energy. Now, another important concept is being introduced by Nikita. I have told you that inside the cell, inside the body of the cell, there are chemical agents, and their duty is that they dissipate their chemical energy. They dissipate themselves, means they dissipate their chemical energy, do the work, and by the help of this work done, they convert their chemical energy into electrical energy. And now I am introducing you people an electrical instrument, which is a filament lamp here. And you people can see that when this electrical energy, or when those electrons flow, when those electrons flow through the body of the lamp, the electrical energy converts itself into the light energy. Beta, if in place of this lamp, I'm going to introduce a doorbell, then when the electrons do flow through the doorbell, doorbell is a kind of electrical instrument which is being made deliberately in such a manner that when electrical energy or electrons do flow through the doorbell, through the circuit of the doorbell, the doorbell converts electrical energy into sound energy. If I'll connect a heater, an electrical heater in place of this filament lamp, then when electrical energy or the electrons do flow through the electrical heater converts its electrical energy, or converts the input of electrical energy into output of heat energy. So all the electrical instruments which are being used by us, I repeat, please listen it carefully. All the electrical instruments which are being used by the people of science, which are being used in our houses, which are being used in our school, all those electrical instruments which are being used by us has actually, or are actually, converting the electrical energy into the required energy at that particular moment of time. As an example, when we switch on the lamp, we are trying, to get the light energy at that moment. We need light energy at that moment. That's why we are going to switch on the electrical lamp. So by switching on the electrical lamp, actually we are connecting or making the connection of the cell with the lamp as a complete connection. And the moment the connection is being completed, the moment the circuit is being completed, this particular lamp starts glowing up. Yes, any question, my child, at this moment? Now I'm in a position to introduce the definition of electrical current. But before that, I want to entertain your questions. Shabash.
Sir, could you please re-explain the part about the electric heater?
But I'm saying, whatever electrical instrument we are going to use in this circuit, whether we are using an electrical lamp, whether we are using an electrical heater, whether we are using the doorbell, whatever electrical instrument is going to be used by us in this closed circuit. Closed circuit is actually the name of this circuit which is being flashed on the screen at the present moment. This particular circuit has the source. The source is the name which is being used by me for the very first time. This is the source. This cell is actually the source of electrical energy. So we have a source of electrical energy. We have the connecting wires present here. We have an electrical instrument here. So whether we are using the electrical lamp, or we are using the electrical heater, or we are using the electrical heater or electrical lamp or whatever electrical instrument are people using. Actually, this electrical instrument has to convert the electrical energy into the desired energy. As an example, when this electrical lamp is being used, it is going to convert its electrical energy, the electrical energy provided to it, into light energy. Yes, come on.
Okay, sir.
Any other question, beta? Now I'm in a position to deduce the definition of electrical current, but I'm not going to introduce it today because we have almost reached to the maximum time. So please ask the question so that in the next lecture we can begin our chapter of electrical current by introducing the definition of electrical current. So shabash.
Sir?
Come on, ask the questions. Yes.
Sir, sir, when we switch on air conditioners, to what form of energy is electrical energy converted?